Our administrator chats with astronaut Nick Hague. Osiris-Rex breaks for a certain asteroid. And what landing site is right for our next mission to Mars? A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On the latest episode of Watch This Space, our administrator Jim Bridenstine chats via satellite with astronaut Nick Hague. Hague is back in Houston just days after he and Russia's Alexei Ovchinin safely made a ballistic landing in Kazakhstan on October 11th when the launch of their Soyuz spacecraft to the International Space Station was aborted due to an anomaly.
If you would, just share with us how you're feeling.
All things considered, being able to walk away from something like that with only a couple, you know, bruises or bumps, physically, I'm doing awesome.
Russia's space agency is investigating the failure while NASA and space station partners evaluate potential changes to upcoming station activities. To see the administrator's entire conversation with Hague, go to nasa.gov/watchthisspace. Jim Morhard was sworn in as NASA's 14th Deputy Administrator on October 17th. Morhard previously served as the U.S. Senate's Deputy Sergeant at Arms and as Staff Director of the Senate Appropriations Committee. Our OSIRIS-REx spacecraft is in the midst of a six-week series of maneuvers designed to fly the spacecraft through a precise corridor toward asteroid Bennu. On October 15th, OSIRIS-REx used its main engine thrusters to perform the second braking maneuver designed to slow the spacecraft's speed relative to Bennu. The spacecraft is scheduled to arrive at the asteroid in early December to perform a series of flybys over Bennu's poles and equator. NASA has announced a call for lunar surface instrument and technology payloads that will fly to the moon on commercial lunar landers as early as next year or 2020. The agency is working with U.S. industry and international partners to expand human exploration from the moon to Mars. The moon has scientific value and the potential to yield resources such as water and oxygen in relatively close proximity to Earth to help sustain deep space exploration. Hundreds of scientists and exploration enthusiasts discussed potential landing sites for our Mars 2020 mission at a workshop this week in Glendale, California. Recommendations from this fourth and final landing sites workshop will be provided to NASA headquarters, where a final selection is expected to be announced by the end of the year. Experience Insight is a new web app from our Jet Propulsion Laboratory that provides an interactive 3D look at the spacecraft technology and scientific objectives of our InSight mission to Mars. The mission, which is scheduled to arrive at Mars on November 26th, will use a lander to probe deep beneath the red planet's surface to help us better understand how rocky planets, including Earth, were created. Check out Experience InSight for yourself at go.nasa.gov/insight-webapp.
NASA sends trillions upon trillions of bits of data to Earth, unraveling long-held mysteries about the universe.
On October 16th, we released The Invisible Network, our new limited edition podcast that highlights technologies crucial to spaceflight yet often overlooked. Each episode journeys through innovation and exploration missions, sharing lesser-known stories of the space agency's history and the space communications and navigation projects, helping take NASA into the future. All six episodes can be downloaded on NASA's website, SoundCloud, and Apple Podcasts. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.